Once upon a time, the FDA approved a shiny new treatment for type 2 diabetes. And if you flip ahead a few chapters in that story, you get hordes of rich people leveraging lax doctors, quasi-regulated pharmacies, and loads of money for the opportunity to inject violence into their guts. So how did we get from point A to point B? Well, it comes down to two forces. What that treatment, semaglutide, does, and the absolutely bonkers things celebrities, and at least one non-celebrity, will do to get it. But before we get into all that, let's start with the basics. What on earth is a semaglutide? Medically known as a GLP-1 receptor agonist, markedly known as Ozempic or Wegovy, and endearingly known as Gluty to its friends, semaglutide is a 2-amino acid-off imitation of a hormone called glucagon-like peptide 1. Hormones are your body's messengers, telling you things like, it's sleepy time, make more red blood cells, or in the case of testosterone, eat raw steaks atop a horse. GLP-1 is a hormone your body releases when you eat, and it reaches receptors all over, telling your pancreas to cook up more insulin, your stomach to digest slower, and your brain to feel less hungry. So if your body struggles to make insulin, i.e. you have diabetes, sending in semaglutide to poke your GLP-1 receptors helps what insulin you do have get the job done better. Now, like any drug, once-weekly semaglutide injections come with side effects. These include nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, abdominal pain, constipation, and even some more serious issues. But the big side effect, the one that's making everyone nuts, is weight loss. An average 8 to 14 pounds, or about 3.5 to 6.5 kilograms, will vanish in a matter of weeks thanks to Ozempic users' suppressed appetites. For an average person, that's as much weight as you'd lose cutting off your left arm or even your right arm. That side effect, hungerless weight loss, is how semaglutide went from a handy drug for a specific patient population to a short-supplied obsession for the rich and famous. Because while many people are living with type 2 diabetes, many more are living with another sinister condition called wanting to be skinnier, and to them, Ozempic looks like a cure. Now, whether or not dropping 8 pounds will eradicate a person's body image struggles isn't really for you and I to say, even though it sounds unlikely. But with gala season coming up and self-perception being a never-ending nightmare, the 1% have gone all in on Ozempic, spurring a 6-month-long shortage for the patients who actually need it. Poke around online and you'll taste the unhinged energy around Ozempic. From the woman who feels, quote, better than everyone because she doesn't eat as much anymore, to the genuinely haunting phrase, quote, never too rich, never too thin. But how are all these people getting Ozempic without a medical need? After all, it's a prescription drug, right? Right. But technically, doctors are allowed to prescribe off-label Ozempic if they want, and with all the hubbub, it's a great way to attract and retain patients. Still, if you don't have the diabetic levels of A1C in your blood or qualify as obese according to the blatantly pseudoscientific BMI chart, your insurance won't pay for your shots, meaning you'll pay around $1,000 a month out of pocket, which, for the richest and most desperate among us, is nothing. What's $1,000 a month for the pleasure of explosive diarrhea? I can think of literally no better uses for the money, except these. Getting the prescriptions filled is another story. Some people get their drug fixed through a normal pharmacy, or, up until recently, Canadian pharmacies where the drug is cheaper. But many rely on compounding pharmacies. Their real purpose is custom meds, so if you're allergic to some ingredient or can't swallow pills and need a liquid, they can cook up a version of your drug that suits you. But in this case, since Ozempic was on the shortage list, they got to compound and sell an off-brand version of it despite the patents. Compounded drugs aren't FDA approved and the pharmacies aren't very tightly regulated, but they end up doing the same job. You hope. And if you think this all sounds a bit sketchy, you're right. Injecting unapproved diabetes drugs that haven't gone through long-term medical trials on non-diabetic patients is sketchy. It's also uncool, as you're taking medication away from people who actually need it, and gross because, and I can't emphasize this enough, it ravages your bowels. Could it possibly be this easy to do something this dumb? I had to know. So, armed with my credit card, no relevant medical conditions, and for some reason this pair of pants, I sent HEI's outside correspondent Amy to get the prescription that has all of Hollywood literally pooping themselves. How long would it take? How many doctors would she have to see? What sordid web of lies would she have to— oh, wait, she already got it. Yep, after weeks scouring Reddit threads and ZocDoc reviews and creating a fake backstory, medical history, and 3 backup plans, Amy scored the prescription in the first 15 minutes of her first attempt. And 5 of those minutes were just a video about how to use the pens, which she mostly ignored in favor of peeping the doctor's YouTube recommendations. Mostly classic rock covers and tragically 0 of my videos. No talk of side effects, just a warning insurance wouldn't cover it and that the Canadian government was cracking down, and he wrote the script. If this sounds like it was too easy, it was. The only friction in the process was that Amy, like many cool youngs, hadn't seen a primary care doctor in about 6 years, and apparently, if you don't go to a doctor for 6 years, there's almost no way around them drawing blood. And let's make one thing crystal clear before we go. Amy did not get her prescription filled. In fact, she burned it. Well, actually the doctor uploaded it through a portal, so she printed it out and then she burned it. Then she roasted a marshmallow over it, because eating food is not a medical condition you need to get fixed. It's actually one of the best parts of being alive. Don't anyone tell you otherwise. So, getting an Ozempic prescription was way too easy. But you know what's easier? Unlocking the next stage of your career with the help of this video's sponsor, Skillshare. And they won't even draw your blood. You probably know Skillshare from all those film editing, photography, and illustration classes YouTubers are always hyping. They're actually useful for even more than the actual doing of creative work, since they have tons of career-focused classes too. Ones like Liz Brindy's on time management for creatives, which is perfect for busy people, like me and I'm guessing many of you, who still have to make time for their creative work. Or Wahida Sami's resume writing class, which will help you land pretty much any job. And after all that career building, you can kick back with this class about cooking chicken over live fire. So if you're ready to take your career to the next level, or to cook a chicken over a live fire, you should definitely join Skillshare. It's really the best resource for anyone who likes to learn new skills to get ahead in work, school, or creative pursuits. And now is the perfect time to do it, because the first 1,000 of you to click the link in the description will get a 1-month free trial. You'll be supporting this channel when you do, so thanks in advance.